market has a lot of competition. How do you handle the competition? Very interesting, you know. Years ago when I used to do this kind of, you know, conversation with people. So when people ask me about competitors, you know, a lot of competitors and they're butchering us, they're reducing the price and things like that. I would ask them a simple question, you know, who is your competitor? So if I was asking a Mahindra, you know, Mahindra salesperson, Mahindra and Mahindra tractor dealer, you know, tractor salesperson, he says my competitor is John Deere, my competitor is Sonalika tractors, my competitor is Ford tractors, my competitor is, you know, Tuffe, my competitor is Eicher, my competitor is Escorts, my competitor is, you know, so many companies, you know, and they will keep talking about all these companies that are there. So I would say to that Mahindra fellow or to any other fellow that Sonalika is your 11th competitor, that Eicher Motor is your 12th competitor, that, you know, Escorts is your 13th competitor, that Ford Tractors is your 14th competitor, that Tuffe is your 15th competitor. So they are 11, 12, 13, 14. So whichever names they give me, I tell them that it's 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 competitors. So they keep on asking me, so what is the first 10 competitors? Now let me tell you, my dear friends. Before the 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, which are tangible competitors, where you can see them, hear them, feel them, there are 10 intangible competitors, which is what kills you before the 11th one, who is a tangible competitor, attacks you. So people ask me, what are these 10 intangible competitors? According to me, the first intangible competitor that you cannot see is change. If everything around you is changing and you're not changing, that's your first competitor. Who is your second competitor? You know, resistance to change. If the first one is you're not changing, now that you came to know that you have to change and you resist change, that's your second competitor. Resistance to change is your second competitor. The third competitor is public knowledge of your product. You know, you have to make a whole lot of effort to make a lot of new people, new public know about your product. If new and new people are not knowing about your product, which is the public knowledge of your product, if people are not knowing about your product, that's your third competitor. So the fourth competitor, if I may put this here out here, is known as the customer's mind. Whenever a customer is thinking of buying a tractor, it should be Mahindra, 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 Mahindra. You must occupy the mind of the customer for anything. Whenever it is training, it should be smart, 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 smart. Whenever it is an inspirational speaker, it should be Santosh Nair, Santosh Nair, Santosh Nair, Santosh Nair, Santosh Nair. And that is what, if the moment people think about anything and, you know, you occupy their customer's mind, that's your, if you're not occupying the customer's mind, that's your fourth competitor. The fifth intangible competitor is the product concept. Sometimes it's known as a product concept. Sometimes some products is your favorite products. You sell faster, there may be a demand in the market. So you fall in love with that particular product. It's known as a product concept. You therefore don't look at the range of things that you have. And therefore, since you don't look at the range, now others may want that range, and you're not talking about the range. So what happens? You fall in love with the product. People go for that other range, and when they look at other products, they find out that the other company also has better things and a whole lot of other things, and they become fans of that particular thing. Therefore, always give what the customer wants. But a man who has fallen in love with the product concept, he has fallen in love with a single product, he has not upgraded himself on the other products, that's an intangible competitor number 6. The seventh intangible competitor is the bigness mentality. You must say we are from LIC or Mahindra, we are the biggest tractors guy, or we are the biggest insurance company. That's known as the bigness mentality. The moment you have this attitude that we are very big and nobody can touch us and nobody can, you know, like look at Maruti. It has never had this bigness mentality. It's got 50+% for the last 15 years, 20 years, 50% of the market share. They don't have the bigness mentality that anybody will come and take away our market. We are not bothered. We are Maruti. We are the biggest, the largest market share. They don't have that bigness mentality. And the moment you have this bigness mentality, that's your seventh competitor. The eighth competitor is known as broken chains. Broken chains is nothing but you break a commitment or you know, there is a broken communication from you. So there is a breakdown in communication, there is a breakdown in commitment, there is a chain that has got broken. So it's known as broken chain. So service goes bad or something like that, and you don't honor your word, that's a broken commitment, that's your, you know, eighth competitor. The ninth competitor is known as things that go bump in the night. Now, things that go bump in the night is nothing but natural calamities. You know, there can be an earthquake and so your building got destroyed, there can be a flood, there can be excessive rains, and there is completely washout of your factory, or the fire got, you know, there was a fire that got caught in your factory and the fire destroyed your own factory. Now, this is known as things that go bump in the night. These are natural God's way of doing things to you. You have no control, but what control you have is to get back up fast and come back. Yesterday fire happened, today you are in the market reconstructing the building, reconstructing your products, reconstructing your strategies, reconstructing your activities. You have forgotten that a fire got, you know, caught yesterday and things like that. You're not cribbing about it, crying about it, you're not worried about it, you're not, you know, sermonizing people, you're not feeling demotivated, you're not feeling cheated about the way the whole thing happened, so things can go wrong. The moment you don't come back fast, that will act as your ninth competitor. And the tenth and the biggest intangible competitor, my dear friends, is you yourself. People can stop you temporarily. You can stop yourself permanently. And that is what is the essence of life. You have to see that you conquer all these 10 intangible competitors. Before the 11th one, which is John Deere, or the 12th one, which is Tough A, or the 13th one, which is Sonalika Tractors, or the 14th one, or 15th one, or the John Deere, or, you know, Case New Holland, or whoever may be the 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th. If you handle the 10 intangible competitor, you don't have to worry about the tangible competitor, because you're constantly changing, you're challenging the status quo, you're not falling in love with your product, you don't have a business mentality, you know, all these things will lead you to be in control of life. And that is what, according to me, is how do you handle competition. You just keep on doing greater and better and different things that outsmarts your competitor, makes them irrelevant, you know, in front of you. All the very best, and thank you very much.